from the things of this world. Put down your pride and put down your arrogance and come to Jesus before it's too late. For it's the pride of life that keeps people from coming to the Lord. They're prideful in their cars. They're prideful in their money. They put their noses in the air to the preaching of Jesus Christ. When God has demonstrated his love towards us through his son Jesus, that although we was yet sinners, Jesus Christ came and died for us. Sir, do you want to see a demonstration of God's love? Look at the cross. God's love is demonstrated at the cross of Jesus Christ. God demonstrated his love by sending his son for us to die for our sins, that we might find redemption and salvation. But we must be willing to come. We must be willing to repent. Save yourself from this wicked and perverse generation and come to the Lord. Be ye reconciled to God today. Be ye reconciled to God today through the sacrifice of his son Jesus. For time is running out, my friends, and God is offering forgiveness to all those who are willing to humble themselves and come to the mercy seat of God. But time is running out, my friends. Time is against you, and before you know it, you will breathe your last breath, and you won't be here any longer. But you're going to be somewhere. Sir, I see you coming back again. We got a lot of people out here. They don't want to hear about Jesus. They don't want to come to the Lord. We live in a God-rejecting generation. But you must be willing to put down your hatred towards God and come to the Lord and receive his love. You must be willing to put down the hatred that you have for God's word and come to the Lord Jesus and receive his love. If not, my friend, you will be found naked at the judgment seat. You will stand before God in your rags of sin, and God is going to judge you, my friends. And your judgment will be for eternity. You will face the suffering of the torments of hell because you have rejected salvation. God is offering salvation to all people, but people do not want God's salvation. They have hatred in their hearts towards God. And when you preach the word of the gospel, it's an offense to a rebellious generation. The word of God is offense to a sinful generation. They don't want to hear nothing about Jesus. They don't want to hear nothing about turning away from their sins, because we live in a sin-loving generation that worships self. The Bible says, now this is the condemnation, that the light has come into the world, but men, they love darkness rather than light because their deeds are evil. And this is why people do not come to Jesus. They love the darkness and they don't like the light. This is why men have a hatred for God in their hearts. This is why the word of God is an offense to a rebellious generation. It's because they love darkness rather than light. Their deeds are evil. Their deeds are wicked. And they are not willing to put down their sin to come and receive this gift of salvation that God is offering through his son Jesus Christ. They rather keep going on in their sinful living and live their life all the way to the end and die only to face the judgment for their sin, and they spend an eternity in hell. And this is what awaits all those who reject the salvation of God. This is what awaits all those who love their sin and hate righteousness. If you don't want to be right with God, just keep doing what you're doing. If you want to go to hell, just don't pick up the Bible. Just don't pray to the Lord. Just don't surrender your life. You just keep living and doing what you want to do. And you can guarantee at the end of your life, when you breathe your last breath, you are going to step into hell, my friends. You will step into an eternity of suffering. But while it is still today, you can come to the Lord. While it is still today, God is offering salvation for all sinners. But the sinner must turn, or the sinner is going to burn. If the sinner does not come to the Lord, he will meet God in the final judgment. And God is going to be ruthless in the execution of his justice against all those who have rejected his salvation. See, God is offering salvation to all people. This is a whosoever gospel. God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him, that they should not perish, but that they should have everlasting life. This is a whosoever gospel, my friends. Whosoever is willing to humble themselves and come to the mercy seat of Jesus Christ may receive this precious gift of salvation that God is offering through the sacrifice of his Son. But my friend, time is running out. And today I am sent here to warn you, if you reject the salvation of the Lord Jesus, you're going to go to hell. You are going to face the judgment for your sin. And I am pleading with you today to come to the mercy seat of God while you are still alive. Come to the mercy seat of Jesus Christ while there's still breath in your body. Because you're not promised tomorrow, ma'am. You can leave this red light and you can get in a wreck and lose your life. Is your heart right with God? Are you ready to meet thy God, ma'am? Because there is a day of accountability coming, and you can't run from him forever. There is a day where we will all stand before the judgment seat of God. For God has appointed a day of judgment where he is going to judge the world in righteousness through his Son Jesus.